My name is Stanislaw Robert Liberta with AV Ultra, and in this lesson, we're going to be talking about compound clips in Final Cut Pro 10. Looking at my browser, I have a title and I have a little animation of my logo coming together in one clip. If we come down to my timeline, you can see I have a very similar kind of compound clip here. I have a logo, I have some text, I have a transition that's happening that goes to another text block and then transitions out. So I have a few different transitions and I have a few different clips that are all bundled together in one flattened clip. There's a couple different ways I can tell if I'm using compound clips or not. One, in my timeline, I can see that I've got this little icon here. It looks like one clip connected to another clip. If I go to my browser window, you'll see that I have that same icon on any clip that is a compound clip. If I double click on my compound clip, that lets me see exactly what it's comprised of. So this is looking at the timeline inside of that compound clip. So the benefits of using compound clips are, one, it's a way to precomp or nest your clips together. So if you're used to Adobe Premiere or Avid where you're pancaking different clips or your timelines together, this is effectively doing the same thing. A second benefit is to quickly and easily iterate different kinds of clips together. For example, if I wanted to just get into this clip and replace this with something like this, now I have a different connected clip that is a part of my timeline that I didn't have to do a lot of changes for. If there's a logo change across something, or if you need to quickly and easily replace a bunch of different text that iterates through a chain of different items, this is one quick, easy way to do this. So before we get into making these compound clips, I want to point out the main reason why you want to bundle these things together instead of just having them in all these different stacks. Right now I have this slate that opens up with a transition. That transition affects both my logo and my title. It transitions out to somewhere else and it affects everything at once. If I don't have a compound clip, here's what that will look like. So this is the same exact timeline you just saw. The only difference here is those clips are broken up in my timeline. If I play this back, notice it comes on. I have a transition here. That transition is only affecting that title text. It's not affecting everything at once. Lastly, it's a great way to organize different clips together. For example, I have this small production I put together for a 48-hour film. If I know that this whole section is complete and I've got a bit of a picture lock, what I can do is just compound clip these items together so it's flattened. And now all the effects and everything I did to that is flattened. And if I pass this on to somebody else, chances are they're not going to accidentally forget something or move something. It's all locked together in one spot. And let's talk about how we can create our own compound clips. In my lesson 10, compound clips, you can see I have a series of my different icons. So I have my background, I've got my text layer, I've got my compressor, my logo, Final Cut, and motion. To make a compound clip, go to File, New, Compound Clip, or what's easier for me is just hit Alt-G on my keyboard. And I'm gonna call this Apple icon compound clip demo. And all that does is it flattens those things together. This is still playing for 10 seconds and 15 frames. And if I open this up, you can see I have these different items. I might want to fade this one in, then this one, and then this one. So I can do that by just trimming these icons back. You know what? Let's grab this guy here, make it less confusing. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to add a cross dissolve to this clip, and this clip. You know what? Let's take them off at the end there. And I'm also going to fade in this text as well. And I'll get out of my compound clip. Notice my total duration doesn't change. This is still 10 seconds and 15 frames, but now I have a bundled animation that I can work with. So let's talk about making changes to these compound clips. Because like we saw before, any changes that I make to this clip will change throughout everything. I might not want to change this specifically. Maybe I want a second version that instead of having these Apple icons has Adobe icons. So I'm going to come up to my browser and I'm going to go to my Apple icon and I'm going to hit Command D. This creates a second copy that's identical to the first one of my compound clip. I'm going to rename this and just call this Adobe icons. And we're going to double click in the Adobe icon ones. And I'm just going to remove out these Apple clips. So we're just going to get rid of these. And I'm going to change my text. So instead of Final Cut Apple Motion and Compressor, it's going to say Adobe Premiere and After Effects. And I'm going to add those icons right in here. And I'm going to use my transform controls just to resize this. And I'm just going to copy those attributes by hitting Command C, Shift Command V, and we want to take that scale. And let's take the position too, because that way all we have to do is move it over to the left. And it looks like that icon is just a bit bigger. So now effectively, I have two totally different compound clips that are based on the same original compound clip. So I can play them back to back and I can adjust them freely. So that's a quick, easy way to put together some simple animations and then put them together so that way they're reusable at any time. So instead of having to build something like this over and over again, you can just build it once in Final Cut and it's there forever as long as you have that media available. Again, my name is Stanislaw Robert Liberta with AV Ultra, and hopefully you found this lesson useful. Thanks a lot for watching.